moving on to the 125-pound weight class. Jay Criz, a senior from Bonhomme, versus Ben Gillette, from a junior who is from Redfield. These two met earlier in the year, and it was an overtime match, so this is going to be a good match, with Gillette winning in overtime down in the winter wrestling tournament. So
the 125-pound championship at stake, but also watch the wrestler in the blue with the black trim, Redfield, and that will be the team point implication on this.
See, we're in the underhook there with Criz.
Redfield in sixth place, but a win here would push them all the way up to fourth.
That's right. And they have two wrestlers left yet to wrestle in the finals, too, after Ben Gillette. Criz doing a nice job. At the beginning of the tournament, and you look through the brackets and throughout the year, you kind of ask Criz there looking for the takedown. Gillette has a nice job with the wizard. What the wizard is he's got that elbow over his arm, so did a nice job there. Didn't let him score the points. That's one thing that Criz has to do if he wants to win the match. He's got to score points there when he's in on a shot like that. So working on hand control there. Going back to what I was saying here, you look at your brackets as they released them during regions, and you look at the 125-pound weight class, and this is one of the premier weight classes of the tournament. So both two extremely good athletes wrestling here for the 125-pound championship.
As much as any, being here is a real accomplishment. Being on the podium is an extra.
Exactly. There was multiple state championship, multiple finalists in this weight class. So Gillette was warned for stalling. Now he's in on the takedown there. Short time. Looks like he's got to come around. Up. Oh, he's got the takedown. Prior to that, Gillette was cautioned for stalling. So
little referee motivation.
Little referee motivation. That's right. Got him going here. Got the takedown. Now 20 seconds to go here. Gillette's going to work to try to ride him out. Criz comes to his feet. Gillette does a nice job of going back down. And
coaches are up. What as a coach, what do you tell a wrestler at this time? Is he really listening to you?
Well, it's tough to say. You know, you try to, you know, give him some words of encouragement, kind of hit a move, but you know, the wrestler in his mind knows what he's going to do, mm-hmm. and knows what it's going to take to get the job done. So. And these guys have both been there before, so they know what they need to do. Gillette takes the lead 2-0.
Wrestling match, three periods, a minute and a half in the first, two in the second, two in the third.
That's 2 minutes in the first period. So.
And then that's six total. That's
six,
right?
Total,
okay.
You bet.
Six total, two in each, and we're entering the third period right now.
Criz went down as Gillette deferred, so Criz is going to try to work for that escape. Now, here's the thing. He needs to take him back to the mat so he wouldn't get called for stalling, or else Criz would get a point. So did a nice job of returning him to the mat. Now he's got to work to maintain, you know, work to try to get a turn, work to control the wrist, bar and up arms. Okay, now he lets him go. It's 2-1. Minute 30 to go. Like I said, these two met earlier this year. Gillette won in overtime. So it's going to be a close match. Good sprawl by Gillette. Criz needs to make sure he's really working on his toes there to get in deep on a single or a double. Gillette works up. Now Criz has the wizard in. Criz needs to maintain that wizard. And he does. So we're still going both up. It's going to be still 2-1. Gillette leading. You can see Criz here. He's trying to force the issue a little bit because he knows that Gillette has been warned for stalling. So if he gets warned again, that means Criz gets a point. But he's got to make sure he forces the issue. So, and Gillette, he did a nice job there of not getting, you know, of letting the referee know, yeah, I'm going to be the aggressor in this match. So,
Gillette from Redfield in the blue and in the dark singlet, blue trim in the dark. Chris in the light with the light blue trim.
21 seconds to go here. These guys, you know, they're going to be a little bit precautious, but they are going to take their chance to score if they can. Gillette's going to have to make something happen in this series here. He's going to have to go forward. There he was. He had a nice little shot there.
It's the end of the second period.
We go to the third with a 2-1 lead for Gillette. And he's going to go down.
Surprised?
A little bit. I've watched him throughout the tournament there. Mm-hmm. And when it's has been his choice, he's been going up on his feet. So I am a little bit surprised there because, you know, he's a very good wrestler on his feet. And I haven't seen him wrestle in the down position much. So. Mm-hmm. He's got to work his way to get out and, like I said, maintain to keep working hard. And like I said, Chris, he's the one that's down, so he's got to be looking for some near fall points. Or if he can't get him, he might have to decide to cut him to, and when I say cut him, give him the escape point to make sure that he gave himself a shot to get the takedown. There
and
he does.
There he does. So now 3-1 and Chris in the white hoping to get the takedown to tie it up.
And that's something that it may come into play here with the stall warning there early. Gillette has to stay on that, be the aggressor. It may be a 3-2 match, so. Gillette from Redfield looking for his second state title. There was our stall warning right there. And he gave up 1 point, so it is 3-2. He does have the high single up. No back, but he is. 51 seconds. Chris looks like he's going to have control here. He needs to make sure he keeps screwing his hip. Gillette does a great job right there of coming back, coming around. Okay. Good call there by the referee. It was a potentially dangerous call. The knee, as you can see, was kind of out of position there, and it was going against the way it's supposed to go. So good call. We're going both up. 37 seconds to go, so. Chris needs to stay aggressive. Seconds to go in the 125-pound championship match. Jay Chris from Bonholm, Ben Gillette of Redfield.
And here comes the crowd.
Yep, crowd's coming in. It was a stalemate call. They're going to put him back in the middle. Watch Gillette do a quick shot. There was a stalling call. Now it's 2 seconds left. No score. Both up. Okay, we had a stalling call, which gave Chris 1 point. Tie score 3-3. Chris went for the scramble, probably not knowing he had the stalling call.
Overtime.
And with the scramble situation, they're both up. So good job on both wrestlers. Now, collect your breath here. Get a little breather.
Okay, now, and the 1 minute overtime. What's the situation?
Okay, first wrestler that scores will win the match in the first overtime period. So, like I said, you have to stay aggressive. You have to keep working. If no score wrestles, then we go into double overtime with some 30-second goals. Each wrestler will have that chance. Mm-hmm. See Coach Stadman there telling his wrestler, get back to the center of the mat. Force the issue. Gillette in on the single. Chris hooks the leg. He has to keep his hips up. No score yet given. 34 seconds. He's rotated his hips pretty well. Gillette still. There's two takedowns. The 125-pound champion, Jake Perez from Bottom, wins over Ben Gillette. Great match. Great match by both guys. Wow, good match. A lot of action.
They left it all on the mat. You can see it on their face.
Jake Perez, a senior from Bonham.
And the state champion at 120.